this is my audience right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, yourself included. So my topic is, should student athletes get paid? So how many of you here are athletes? So do you guys know anyone at any college level that is struggling to get food, money, and other supplies? 1, 2. So if the NCAA or your school chose to pay you guys, what would be the advantages and disadvantages?
Advantage would be like getting food, paying off college like that your scholarship hasn't covered, or other things that are a necessity for just living on campus.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think an advantage for it would be time-wise, because when you're an athlete, you take out almost as much time as if you were to have a job. So if you get a job as a student athlete, you effectively have three jobs: student, athlete, and then your actual job if you want to have enough money to eat some days. So
because I know as a lacrosse player, you spend a lot of time and effort into your sport. I'm pretty sure you guys practice for 5 hours a day.
Yeah, no, I agree with what RC said. It really just frees up like how much time, stress wise, how much is on your plate.
You, Trevor.
Playing devil's advocate, I think that the disadvantages to paying college athletes is that it kind of opens up a can of worms, because you can look at it from any perspective of a Division I, Division II, Division III athlete, but Division I athletes are on a higher scale. They're televised a lot more. They have more of a shot just through general standard compared to the D2, D3 athlete of actually getting that chance to go pro and actually getting a stipend for their talent. So doing that can open up a can of worms for possible problems in the NCAA.
Yeah, because I know me personally, playing two sports, I play basketball and football. It takes a lot of time out of my day, especially when you work and you also play two sports, which means you gotta practice twice a day. And it sucks when you get home at 12 o'clock, you're tired, you're hungry, and you can't really provide yourself with anything. That's all. So, is there sport a job? The typical player devotes 43.3 hours per week to the sport, which is 3.3 more hours than a typical American work week. Although the NCAA claims the college athletes are just students, the NCAA tournament schedules require athletes to miss classes for nationally televised games that bring in revenue. At some schools, the road to NCAA men's national championship may require certain athletes to miss up to a quarter of all class days during the spring semester. So if you think about it, these athletes are investing more in the sport than they are in their education and pretty much get nothing in return. So college sports is a job. So how much does the school make and how much does a student athlete make? The NCAA makes about $10-11 billion a year in revenue from college sport, which is more than the National Basketball Association and the National Hockey League. So how much money does a student athlete get from that $11 billion?
Nothing.
Absolutely. So last year, the University of Alabama reported $143.3 million in athletic revenue, which is more than all 30 NHL teams and 25 of 30 NBA teams. So much of the revenue collected from the college athletics do not go directly back into the classroom, the student, or their life. It usually goes to coaches, ADs, and other athletic department people. So here's a picture of the athletic department revenue versus the college expenses. So the red line over here is how much schools give up scholarship-wise, and the blue line is how much money the athletes make off their scholarship. So here you can see the big rise in how much the school makes off the students and how much basically the students are given for their education. Here's a picture of Coach K.
The GOAT.
So, yes. So here's a picture of him. His salary a week is $193,640.
I think that'd be a year.
And his players make zero. And his players are the ones that are making him that money. It's pretty sad. Pretty sad. So, the last reason is they are the face on campus and the face of the university. It's important to note that college student athletes are not only a part of a sports team, they are part of the college's or university's advertising team. For example, the foodie effect used to describe a surge in college admission following a big sports win. It's named for Boston College quarterback Doug Flutie, who won the Heisman Trophy in 1984. The effect of that is that college admissions rose significantly in the following years. Still, colleges and universities use athletic success to promote the school and entice potential applicants. Student athletes would be paid for this and all the additional benefits they provide for the schools. So here's a picture of Johnny Manziel, who basically put Texas A&M on the map and got nothing out of it. Here's a picture from the 2011 college football season. Coaches combined make $53.4 million a year, and the athletes made zero. And of those athletes, there was 13,877 Division I football players. They made $0. So this is my work cited.